There are many mental disorders that manifest themselves in different ways. In general, they are characterized by combinations of abnormal thoughts, emotions, behavioral reactions, and relationships of others. According to the World Health Organization, every fourth to fifth person in the world has a mental or behavioral disorder. Patients with mental disorders may experience various psychical, emotional, cognitive, behavioral symptoms. For example, in terms of emotions, a person can feel particularly miserable and disproportionate to the events unhappy. In thinking, with a mental disorder, logical relationship of thoughts may be violated. Extremely positive or negative judgment about others and about oneself may appear. The ability to critically appraise may be lost. In human behavior, the symptoms of mental disorders are expressed in the form of deviations from accepted in society forms or behavior. Mental disorder is not equal to mental illness. International Classification of Diseases of the 10th Revision, the term mental disorder is used instead of the term mental illness. In this video essay, I want to talk more about the social personality disorder or sociopathy. Sociopathy is a disorder of the human personality, which manifests itself in ignoring social norms and the inability to maintain normal interpersonal relationships. In addition, sociopaths easily break down and quickly switch to aggressions, are impulsive, irresponsible, and have other signs and characteristics. Basically, experts agree that all sociopaths can be divided into two types, latent or passive, can for a long time fully maintain normal behavior and relationship with people, guided by the influence of strong personality, religion, or social norms. In turn, actual active sociopath, when they are in society skillfully, disguise themselves, justifying the expectations of others, but as soon as they are outside the evaluation system, they discard all the impulse taboos. Signs that you see a sociopath. He's charming. He's unpredictable. He does not feel shame, regret, or guilt. He loves to boast. He must win at all costs. He's very smart. He doesn't love anyone. He never apologized. He often presents himself as an eye with high moral principles. Portrait of a sociopath in the series. In the first, Sherlock. Image of Sherlock Holmes, a high-functioning sociopath, fully justified the definition, which he definitely called himself. Although the narcissistic detective cannot be called a vivid representative of sociopathy, he is not inclined to sadism and is capable of love, but he is distinguished by the insensibility and prudence characteristic of the mind forms of this socio-psychologic phenomenon. Sherlock not only cleverly conducts investigations, but also manages the feelings of those around him using the most gullible to achieve his goals. The weakened sense of fear among sociopaths leads to the fact that they commit unusual, often cruel acts, injure those who depend on them, engage in intrigues that are understandable only to themselves. Indeed, the halo of an interesting, active person with whom you will not get bored, cold-blooded, and adroit in their work gives sociopaths a charm that attracts emotionally dependent people who need a leader, as well as other sociopathic lookers for strong emotional stimulus. What specifically expressed Sherlock's sociopathic? In his tendency to manipulate people. When Sherlock needs Molly's help, he gives her compliments and the girl immediately performs his request. Sociopaths are characterized by the desire to emphasize their achievement. He said, "I am a consulting detective, the only one in the world." Sherlock has an inherent block of effect inherent to sociopath, as a result of which it is difficult for him to express his feelings. Sociopaths have a high threshold of excitability, which means that Sherlock needs more powerful reason to feel cheerful and energetic. Because of the high threshold of excitability, sociopaths don't know what fear is. Sociopaths have innate tendencies towards aggressiveness. He's genius. So, Sherlock's sociopathic features are enough for some psychoanalysts in his world to recognize him as a sociopath who functions at a fairly high level. But they are not enough to truly consider Sherlock so, because he really worries about the life and fate of his best friend John Watson. Yes, he does not know how to express his feelings. He cannot understand the emotions of other people. Perhaps in his family it wasn't customary to express his feelings and emotions in verbal form, and he simply didn't have such a skill. All I thought Sherlock calls himself a highly active sociopath, we can conclude that he is not an ordinary sociopath. He is a sociopath who are thought capable of shameless acts. Sherlock is a sociopath who has reached a high level of moral development and is closer to the norm. The second series is House Midi. A sociopath can refuse to hold generally accepted holidays, adopting traditional patterns of thinking. This man doesn't believe anyone and nothing. He checks everything for taste. He likes to repeat the phrase, "Everyone lies," and constantly reveals the lies of patients. There are no laws for him. What specifically expressed Gregory House as sociopathic? Dr. House has an unusual charm. He is very unpredictable. House loves to boast of its genius and success. He is very smart. He is ready to make any sacrifice to find a solution to the puzzle. It is very difficult to get an apology from him. Despite all this, Gregory House is not completely sociopathic. Of course, Gregory is capable of expressing love. He really often is not capable of the emotions that ordinary people show, for example, guilt, empathy, but not because he doesn't know these feelings, but because his view of things is different. From this, we can conclude that House is not a 100% sociopath, but in my opinion, he is still more sociopathic than Sherlock. He is much more cruel and always put his needs above others. Sherlock, despite his selfishness, is ready to do everything for his beloved people.